Hi, hello children, good afternoon all of you. I hope you all are safe at home. So stay home, stay safe. So I am Rajani from KJBV Polaki, Srikakulam district, CRT Mathematics. In the previous session, we already discussed about the sets and the concept of sets, how to define the set and the roster form, set builder form, and how the elements are belonging to the set. All of you, we discussed in the previous session. So today, now we discussed and explained about the exercise 2.1 and also another concept on sets. So first we discuss about the exercise 2.1. First question: which of the following are sets? Justify your answer. First one is the collection of all the months of a year beginning with the letter J. The answer is yes, because the given collection is a set. There are 3 months in a year beginning with letter J. The months are January, June and July. As the given collection is well defined, hence it is a set. If you observe, we know all of you in the year beginning with letter J, the months are January, June and July. So it is well defined set. Next one, the collection of 10 most talented writers of India. It is not a set because the given collection is not a set. There is no rule given for deciding whether a particular writer is talented or not. So it is a not collection of set. Next one, third one, a team of 11 best batsmen of the world. It is not a set because the given collection is not a set. There is no rule given for deciding whether a particular cricketer is best or not. So we cannot decide the best cricketer. So that's why it is not a set. So hence the given collection is not set. Next, fourth one, the collection of all boys in your school. It is a set because the given collection is a set. The collection of all boys in the class is well defined. All of you know all the boys are in a class are well defined. So hence the given collection is a set. There is a rule that is all are boys. So it follows some rule. That's why it is a set. So next one. See the next one. The collection of all even integers. All of you know what is the even integers? 2, 4, 6, 8. The even integers are starting from 2. So etc. are the 2, 4, 6, 8, etc. are the even integers. All of you know. So it is a following some rule. Okay. So that's why the collection of all even integers is a set. As the given collection is well defined, hence it is a set. Next. A is equal to set of all 0, 2, 4, 6 and B is equal to set of all 3, 5, 7 and C is equal to P, Q, R. Then fill the appropriate symbol belongs to or does not belong to. All of you know what are the symbols. Belongs means it is the element is present or not in the set. Does not belongs to means the element is not presented in the set. So if you observe 0 belongs to A or not, 0 is in present A set. 3 is does not belongs to C because 3 is so 3 is not present in set. If you observe all of these, this is the answer of this question. Next one, third one, express the following statements using symbols. All of you know the symbols belongs to or does not belongs to. If the element is belongs to the set, then use the belongs to symbol. If the element is does not belongs to the set, then use the does not belongs to set. So in previous session we told about the belongs to, the symbols of belongs to and belongs. So does not belongs to. First one is X does not belongs to A. Next one is D is an element of the set B. So D belongs to B. Next one belongs to the set of natural numbers. We denote natural numbers as N. So one belongs to N. 8 does not belongs to the set of prime numbers. So 8 does not belongs to P. The prime number set we denote it as P. So the next question. Then we go to next question. All of you check once. Next one. state whether the following statements are true or false. Only you write true or false and write the reason also. Yes does not belongs to the set of prime numbers. All of you know, 5 does not belongs to set of prime numbers. All of you know 5 in present in the prime numbers or not? Yes. Next one. Yes is equal to 5, 6, 7. Next, S is equal set of 5, 6, 7 implies 8 belongs to S. So, 8 is present in in the set of S or not? No. So, it is a false. Next, minus 5 does not belong to W, where W is the set of whole numbers. All of you know what are the whole numbers. So, it is true. Minus 5 is in the set of whole numbers. Next, 8 by 11 belongs to Z, where Z is the set of integers. It is false. Why? Because 8 by 11 is a rational number. All of you know it is a rational number. So it is a every integer need not to be rational number. Okay, next, write the following sets in a roster form. All of you know how to write the roster form. First he given the set builder form. B is equal to set of x such that x is a natural number smaller than 6. So what is the smaller than 6 natural numbers? B is equal to set of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next, C is equal to X such that X is a 2-digit natural number such that the sum of its digits is 8. So that means in the digits of the 2-digit number, if you sum these 2 digits, we can get 8. So, if you observe the 17, 26, 35, 44, 53, 62, 71 and 18, if you add the two numbers in the 2-digit number, then we get easily 8. So, these are the elements in the C set. Next, D. X is such that X is a prime number which is a divisor of 60. So, what are the numbers which is divisor of 60? There are three numbers. One is 2, 3, 5. Next, X such that X is an alphabet. B-E-T-T-E-R. Better. B-E-T-R. Okay, all of you know. Next, where the following sets in the set builder form. He given in the roster form, we can change in the set builder form. So, first you observe what are the numbers. These are multiples of 3 and less than 13. So, x such that x is a multiple of 3 and x less than 13. Next, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. So, if you observe, these are in the form of 2 power x. So, the set of x such that x, 2 power x, and these are natural numbers. So, x there is not belongs to n and x less than or equal to 5. If you take in the power of 2, we take only from 1 to 5. Then we get 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. Next one is 5, 25, 125, 625. If you observe these numbers, these are all powers of 5 from 1 to 4. If you take 5 power 1, 5. 5 power 2, 25. 5 power 3, 125. And 5 power 4, 625. So, x such that x is 5 power x. X belongs to n and x does not, there's less than or equal to 4. Next one, 1, 4, 9, 16, 25. These are all in the square numbers. So, perfect squares. So, x such that x square, x belongs to n and x less than or equal to 10. So, next one. Write the following sets in the roster form. So, x first one is a is equal set of x such that x is a natural number greater than 50 but smaller than 100. What are the numbers greater than 50 and smaller than 100? Natural numbers, these are 51. So, A is equal set of 51, 52, 53, comma, so on, 98 and 99. Okay. Next, B is equal set of all x such that x is an integer, x square is 4. What's the condition? X is an integer and x square is equal 4. So, what are the numbers? If you take minus 2 whole square, then we get 4. Already, also, if you take 2 square, already we get the 4. So, these are two numbers that are B is equal to set of minus 2 comma 2. Next, D equal to X such that X is a letter, the word loyal. So, in the loyal, letter loyal, L-O-Y-A. So, D is equal to set of L comma O comma Y comma A. So, these are the roster forms. Next, match the roster form with the set builder form. So, if you see, there are some roster forms and set builder forms. If you observe first one, 1, 2, 3, 6. So, this is the answer for C.
x such that x is a natural number and divisor of 6. These four numbers are divisor of 6. Next one, if you observe 2 comma 3, these are the first one. X such that x is a prime number and divisor of 6. The condition is prime numbers. 2 and 3 are prime numbers and also divisor of 6. Next one, m comma a comma, set of m comma a comma t comma h comma e comma I comma c comma s. So these letters are in the word of mathematics. So third one is the third one answer is D. So what is the set builder form of third one? X such that x is a letter of the word mathematics. Next one, 1 comma 3 comma 5 comma 7 comma 9. The set of all 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. It belongs to a odd natural number and smaller than 10. All of you know these are odd numbers and smaller than 1. Next one. Next, today we are discussing about some other concepts on set. First one, empty set or null set. That means a set which does not contain any element is called an empty set or a null set. Means the set does not contain, so there is no elements in the set, okay, there is no elements in the set, that set is called empty set. So akkada a elements lekapothe manu oka set lo empty set ani. So if you observe some more examples, r is equal to x such that x is a natural number between 5 and 6, okay, x such that x is a oval, first one is empty, it's empty set because natural numbers between 5 and 6, we cannot write. Okay, so that is the empty set. Next one, vowel, rhythm. In the word of rhythm, there is no vowel. Next one is x such x plus 3 is equal to 0. If you take any number, then we cannot answer. So empty set is denoted by the Greek letter pi. So empty set is denoted by the Greek letter pi or curly brackets. Number of elements is in an L set is 0. So it is denoted by, only pi or curly brackets only. If you denote it as curly brackets in the element pi and curly brackets, if you observe these three are non-empty sets. So we cannot write it as empty set as these two types. So these three are not empty sets. Next one, universal set. A universal set is the collection of all objects in a particular connect. For example, what is the universal set? We see, if we study about the students of a school, the set of all students in that school is a universal set. If you study about the various groups of a people of a state, the set of all people in the state is universal set. So if you observe, what is the universal set? And if you take the entire school, it is a universal set. In that school, there are boys and girls and some classes. So, that's why. So, in the universal set, there are so many sets in the universal set. So, if we study about the various groups of people of state, it is also universal set. Universal set is denoted by the Greek letter mu or u. So, we use the rectangles for representing universal sets in Venn diagrams. So, how do you denote? Next, subset. If all elements of a set A are present in B, then A is said to be subset of B. It means, if you observe one example, if A is equal to set of 2, 4, B is equal to set of 1, 2, 3, 4, we can say A is subset of B. If you observe in the elements of A is present in the elements in B. So, if A is equal to set of all English alphabet and B is equal to set of all vowels in English alphabet, then B is subset of A. So A is equal to set of all English alphabets, means from A to Z in the set present in the A set. B is equal to set of vowels in the English alphabet, means A, E, I, O, U in the present of a V set. So the elements in the V set all are present in the A set. So the set of V is subset of A. So the next one is set of natural numbers N is subset to the set of integers. All of you know set of natural numbers and integers. So N in natural numbers are all are in the present in the integer set. If set A is subset of set B, then we write it as A subset B. If we write it as A subset B, it means the set A is subset of set B has more elements than A. If set A is not subset of set B, then write it as A does not subset of B. Next, subset. If all the elements of set A are present in set B, then A is said to be subset of B. All of you know. So, if take another example, if set A is subset of set B, then write it as A subset are equal to B. If you write A subset to B, it means that set A is subset of set B and B has more elements than A. If set A is not a subset of B, then we will write it as A does not subset to B. Next, null set is subset of every set. If A is non-empty set and pi is a null set, then pi will subset to A. So, pi is subset to all the sets. So, every set has a subset of pi. So, every set is a subset of itself also. So, if A is equal to 1, 2, 3 and A is equal to set of 1, 2, 3, then A is subset are equal to A. So, every set is a subset to itself and null set is subset of every set. So, natural number set is subset to whole number set, is subset to integers, is subset to rational numbers and subset to real numbers. Okay, next one. If all elements of set A are present in B, then A is said to be subset of B. If you observe these sets, possible subsets, number of possible subsets. If you observe, first one is null set. So, the possible subsets are 1, that is 2 power 0. Okay. If you take one element in the set, then possible subsets are null set and itself. So, the number of possible subsets are 2, that means 2 power 1. Next, you observe two elements. If you take two elements in the set x, y, then the number of possible subsets are empty set, the null set and x set, y set and itself. So, the number of possible subsets are 4, that is 2 power 2. Next, if you take three elements in the set x, y, z, the number of possible subsets are empty set and x, y, z, x, y, y, z, x, z and itself x, y, z. So, the possible number of subsets is equal to 2 power 3. If the number of elements in the set is n, then the number of possible subsets for the set is 2 power n. So, if you observe the patterns, so if we take the number of elements rises, then the number of subsets also rises and it in the form of 2 power n. So, if the number of elements in a set is n, then the number of possible subsets for the set is 2 power n. So, this is the condition to find out the subsets of a set. Next one, do this. A is equal to set of all 1, 2, 3, 4 and B is equal to set of 2, 4. C is equal to set of 1, 2, 3, 4, 7 and pi is equal to null set. So, fill in the blanks with a subset or not subset. If you observe this in the elements of A is present in B, or in the elements of C are present in A and B, if you observe that, we easily decide subset or not subset. If you A and B observe, A is not subset to B because the elements of A are not in present, all the elements of A are not present in the B. So, next one, C is not subset to A. If you observe, all the elements in the C are not present in the A set. So, if you observe B and A, all the elements of B are in A. So, like that, we easily denote that A subset C and B subset C, pi is subset to, so pi is subset to every set. So, next one, state which of the following statements are true. First one, pi is denoted by curly brackets. So, it is true. Next one, pi is equal to 0. It is false. Already we know that. Tell that. Next, 0 is equal to 0 is a set of 0. It is not equal. So, it is false. Next one, try this. A is equal to set of 4 quadrilaterals. B is equal to square set of square, rectangle, trapezium, rhombus. State whether A subset B or B subset A. Justify your answer. In set A, we have all types of quadrilaterals including square, rectangle, trapezium and rhombus. That is, all elements of set B are present in set A. If you observe, all the quadrilaterals in the A set. So, in the B set, some quadrilaterals are there. So, B is subset to A because all the elements in the B are present in A.
Next one, if A is equal to set of A comma B comma C comma D, how many subset does the set A have? Already we told that what is the number of subsets. If the set is set have n elements, then the number of subsets is equal to 2 power n. So in the set A, how many number of elements are there? So how many elements are there? 4 elements. So the answer is 2 power 4. 2 power 4 means 16. Next, P is the set of all factors of 5. Q is the set of factors of 25. And R is the set of factors of 125. Which one of the following is false? All of you know what is the So all of you know what are the factors? P is equal to 5. P is equal to 1 comma 5. What is the factors of 25? Q is equal to 1, 5, 25. R is equal to factors of 125. 1, 5, 25, 125. So R is subset to P is the right answer. Next one. Write this. A is the set of all prime numbers less than 10. B is the set of all odd numbers less than 10. And C is the set of even numbers less than 10. Which of the following statements are true? If you observe, A is the set of all prime numbers less than 10. So A is equal to set of all 2, 3, 5, 7. So B is the set of all odd numbers less than 10. So B contains set of 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Next, C is the set of even numbers less than 10. So C contains the set of 2, 4, 6, 8. So in the following statements, which is correct? So A subset B? No. B subset A? No. A subset C? No. C subset A? No. B subset C? No. So, if you observe the three sets, there is no elements in the common. So, pi is subset to every subset. So, that is the correct answer. So, next one. Venn diagrams. A Venn diagram is representing sets pictorically as circles or closed curves within an enclosing rectangle are called Venn-Euler diagram or simply Venn diagram. So, if you denote the Venn diagram as first, we draw the rectangle and after that, in the rectangle, we draw the curves or circles, closed curves. Okay, the sets are denoted by circles. Okay. If for example, A is equal to set of 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and mu is equal to set of 1, 2, so on, 10, then Venn diagram is as follows. First, we draw the rectangle and what are the elements present in mu? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, next one, what are the elements present in A? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So, we write it in A set 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Other elements are out of the A set. We observe another example. A is equal to set of all 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and B is equal to set of 4, 6. Mu is equal to set of 1, 2, so on, 10. Then Venn diagram is as follows. If you observe, first we draw the rectangle and after that, if you observe, what are the elements in A? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. And the elements B also present in A. So that's why first you draw the A circle and after that in the A circle, we draw the B curve. B circle. So in the B circle, what are the elements? 4, 6. These are common elements to A and B. And after that, A and E in the A set 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So if you observe, and the other elements are out of the set A. What are they? 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Okay. Understand how to represent the Venn diagrams in sets. So all of you know that, Amma. So, the next concept, next example, A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, next, B is equal to set of all 2, 4, 6, 8, then the Venn diagram is as follows. If you observe that, there is two common elements, 2 and 4 in the two sets. So, that's why first we draw the universal set mu and after that set A and set B, set A and B are touching with one another. Okay, we draw touching with one another. And if you see, what are the elements in the A? 1, 2, 3, 4. If you see, what are the elements in B? 2, 4, 6, 8. So, here we, so in this way, we represent the Venn diagrams in sets. So the next concept is basic operations on sets. First one is union of sets. The union of set A and set B is the set which consists of all elements of A and B. So the symbol U is used to denote the union. Symbolically we write A U B and usually read it as A union B or A B. Okay ma? If you observe one example that A is equal set of A comma B comma C and B is equal to set of B comma C comma D comma E, then A union B is equal to the set of all elements in the present in the A and B. If we answer this question, so A union B is equal to set of A comma B comma C comma D comma E. If you observe the Venn diagram, it is observe. This is the Venn diagram. So what are the elements present in A? A, B, C. What are the elements present in B? B, C, D. Okay, understand? So A union B means the set which consists of all elements of A and B. Okay, understand? So in the next one, next example. Let A is equal to take A, B, C, set of A, B, C and B is equal to take set of B, comma, C, comma, D, comma, E. Then A union B is equal to set of A, comma, B, comma, C, comma, E, comma, E. Let M is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and N is equal to 4, 5, 6, 7. Then M union N, what is the M union N? So the set of all the elements consist in M and N. So what are the elements in M and N? 1 comma, 2 comma, 3 comma, 4 comma, 5 comma, 6 comma, 7. So the common elements we write it as once only. Next, what are the Venn diagram? If you see M union N diagram here. Next, A union B is equal to, what is the set builder form of A union B is equal to X such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B. This is the set builder form of A union B. That means X belongs to A or X belongs to B. So this is the union of sets. So our next concept is basic operation on sets is intersection of sets. The intersection of sets A and B is the set of all elements which are common in both A and B. That is those elements which belongs to A and also belongs to B. That means the common elements, we take the common elements only in A intersection B. So we denote intersection symbolically by as A intersection B. You see, Amma, read it as A intersection B. For example, if you take let A is equal to set of A comma B comma C and B is equal to B set of B comma C comma D comma E. If you observe, what are the common elements in these two sets B comma C? So then A intersection B is equal to set of B comma C. If you observe the Venn diagram, it is easily find out the A intersection B. It is the Venn diagram of A intersection B. So what are the elements in A? A, B, C. What are the elements in B? B, C, D. So what are the common elements in the both B and C? So that is the answer of A intersection B. Means set of all elements which are common in both A and B. So next concept, next example, let M is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and N is equal to 4, 5, 6, 7, then M intersection N, what are the common element in this? Only 4. So that's why M intersection N is equal to the set of 4. If you observe the Venn diagram, it is here. You can easily find out the M intersection N. What are the elements in M? 1, 2, 3, 4. What are the elements in N? 4, 5, 6, 7. So what are the common element? 4 is yeah. The shading part is denoted as M intersection N. So the intersection of sets, the set builder form of intersection of sets is equal to A intersection B is equal to X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. So in the elements of A intersection B are belongs to A and X belongs to B. So elements are navy set A ki chandali mariyu B koda chindevai. Next one is operations, basic operations on sets, say disjoint sets. What is the disjoint sets? Two sets that do not have elements in common are called disjoint sets. It means it is purely opposite to the intersection. If you observe one example, let A is equal to set of A comma B comma C and B is equal to set of X comma Y comma Z. If you observe these two sets, there is no common elements. So intersection B is equal what? Null set. Means if any intersection is a null set, then it is a called a disjoint set. If you observe the Venn diagram, we easily notice that. Okay, next one. Do this. If you observe then do this, first one is let A is equal to set of 1, 3, 7, 8 and B is equal to set of 4, 2, 6, 7, 9. Find A union B. We already told that how to find the A union B. The elements both in A and B are, we write it as A union B. So if you observe A is equal to 1, 3, 7, 8 union 2, 4, 7, 9. So next step is the total elements are 1, 3, 7, 8, 2, 4, 7, 9. But we do not write in this way. So we write it as ascending order. So A union B is equal set of all 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 9. So manaki ichche elements anevi ee vidhanga unna kuda manu vaatni ascending order lo gaani ascending order lo compulsory raaskodu. So A union B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is the answer. In the A union B means A set loni B set loni elements anni kalipi oka set lo manam raaskovali. So that is called union. Next one, second one. If A is equal set of 6 comma 9 comma 11 and pi is equal null set, find A union pi. So given that A is equal to set of 6 comma 9 comma 11 and pi already we know null set. So A union pi, if you take A and pi union, then what is the answer? That is A, because in the null set there is no elements. So in the both sets only the elements of A are present in A union pi also. So if you observe chesthe A union pi lo A elements untayo alage A lo kuda ave elements untayi. So that's why A union pi is equal to A. So next question, A is equal to set of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and B is equal to set of 2, 3, 5, 7. Find A intersection B. All of you already I told that what is the intersection B? The common elements of A and B. So if we take A and B two sets, then what are the common elements? These are 2, 3, 5, 7 are common. So A intersection B is equal to set of 2, 3, 5, 7. So if you observe, B is also same. So the elements of A intersection B are present in B also. So that's why A intersection B is equal to B. So in this by this question we observe that if B subset to A, okay, then A intersection B is equal to what? B. And observe chesthe B is subset to A kadamma ikkada. So daniki eppudu kuda answer A intersection B is always B. So next one. If A is equal to set of 4, 5, 6 and B is equal to set of 7, 8, then show that A union B is equal to B union A. If you given that, what is given that? A is equal to 4, 5, 6, B is equal to set of 7, 8. So if we take A union B, okay, A is equal to 4, 5, 6 union 7, 8. So what are the total elements in this A union B? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we do B union A. 7, first we write B, 7, 8. Then after A, union 4, 5, 6. Then also we get, what is the answer? The set of 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If you observe, the A union B is the same as B union A. So therefore A union B is equal to B union A. A union B is always B union A. Okay. So our next concept is difference of sets. The difference of sets of sets A and B as the set of elements which belong to A but do not belong to B. That means A minus B. Okay, we denote the difference of A and B by A minus B or simply A minus B. So if you observe one example, let A is equal to A comma B comma C and B is equal to B comma C comma D comma E. So what is the A minus B here? So what is the difference of sets? The difference sets of set A and B as set of elements which belongs to A but do not belongs to B. అంటే ఏకి మాత్రమే చెందాలి ఏ మైనస్ బిలోని ఎలిమెంట్స్, బీకి అసలు చెందకూడదు. సో బీలో ఏవైతే కామన్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఉన్నాయో వాటిని మనం ఇక్కడ స్ట్రైక్అవుట్ చేయాలి. సో వాట్ వి గెట్ ఇఫ్ వి స్ట్రైక్అవుట్ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఇన్ బి, వాట్ ఆర్ ద ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఇన్ బి? బీ కామా సి ఆర్ కామన్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఇన్ బోత్ సెట్స్. సో వి స్ట్రైక్అవుట్ దెన్ ఓన్లీ వి గెట్ ఏ మైనస్ బి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు సెట్ ఆఫ్ ఏ. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ద, if you observe the Venn diagram, this is the difference of sets Venn diagram. So what are the A minus B here? The shading part is A minus B here. Okay, so next we take another example. So let A is equal to A comma B comma C and B is equal to B comma C comma D. I already told what are the A minus B. We strike out the common elements in A and B, that is that are B comma C. So then we get A minus B is equal to set of A. And after that, we do B minus C also. If you take B as first set and A as second set, then first write B comma C comma D comma A minus A comma B comma C set. So what are the common elements in these two? B comma C. So if we strike out the elements in B, then we get the elements in B, only B, that are D comma E. So if you observe, A minus B is same as B minus A? No. So always A minus B is not equal to B minus A. So if you observe the Venn diagram, the shading part is B minus A. So the elements present in B minus A is D comma E. So what we observe, what we notice, that A minus B is equal to set of X such that X belongs to A and X does not belongs to B. అంటే ఏ మైనస్ బిలో ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఎప్పుడు కూడా ఏకి మాత్రమే చెందే, ఓన్లీ బిలాంగ్స్ టు ఏ, డస్ నాట్ బిలాంగ్స్ టు బి. ఒక ఎలిమెంట్ కూడా బీకి చెందిందే ఉండకూడదు. అలాగే బి మైనస్ ఏలో, ఇఫ్ యూ టేక్ బి మైనస్ ఏ, ఎక్స్ సచ్ దట్ ఎక్స్ బిలాంగ్స్ టు బి అండ్ ఎక్స్ డస్ నాట్ బిలాంగ్స్ టు ఏ. సో దీస్ ఆర్ ద కాన్సెప్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ సెట్స్. సో థ్యాంక్ యూ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ. బాయ్. టేక్ కేర్ యువర్ సెల్ఫ్. We will meet next session.